Good morning. It is Friday, and as every Friday, we have a GNOME app review. This time is GNOME Software 3.32, running on Silverblue 30. Speaking of which, if you haven't tried it yet, just do it. Best Linux ever. So, on this review, I will only focus to usability issues and features, and not to actual bugs. Also, I'm only interested on Flatpak, and not on native packages. Anyway, let's start. Application discoverability is perhaps my biggest complaint on GNOME software. In short, I can't find what I want. Here, I'm on Front Page, which is the only place people actually get applications from. Rarely someone will search for apps, or even go into categories, right? On top, we have the featured applications, and everything's fine with this part. Then, it is editor's picks, and that is fine too. Most interesting though, is the recent releases section, that we can see new, or updated apps. But for some reason, it is only limited to a few items, so not very useful. But the super problematic part, is the recommended apps. The recommendations are awful, and they are awful because we don't have metrics. So, software cannot calculate hot or trending apps. And moreover, even the rating system isn't particularly good. The result is that some really great apps are hidden, and some not that good apps are recommended. Another major issue is inside the app details page that there aren't related apps, which is kinda one of the top ways to discover apps. On a smaller problem, GNOME software cannot open a large image, so we can actually see what we are getting. Okay, I know already that the Linux community is super sensitive when it comes to privacy. However, there is a completely wrong view of the aspect. It is one story to send our data to Facebook, and a different story to share our data with GNOME Foundation. At some point, we have to learn to trust some organizations. And at some point, we deserve to have organizations we can trust. So the question is, can we trust GNOME? Philosophy aside, we need to have metrics. As users, we will immediately get the benefit of better discoverability of good apps. Most importantly, as developers we'll get valuable feedback, and see how users respond to things like updates and changes, so we can improve our apps. And we could also see how we compare to similar apps. Metrics is also a strategic move for Flatpak success. For example, Ubuntu Snap gives current active installations numbers, which is a super advantage over Flatpak, for every software creator. And besides, that could be opt-out. Can you imagine if YouTube wasn't giving stats to creators? Nobody would be using it. It is exactly the same in software too. GNOME Cloud Logins is a fantasy story, because there isn't an actual GNOME OS. However, GNOME has single sign-ons already, that we use daily on their web services, like GitLab. Anyway, I'd like to have that integrated to desktop, for a couple of reasons. First, I want GNOME software to know what apps I own, so I can easily get them on the new installation. And second, I want to be able to change my vote, or my comment, in cases that an app gets an update, so my feedback will be more valuable. And I specifically want GNOME accounts. Not Red Hat, and in the Lord's name, no Ubuntu. I want GNOME, because GNOME is community. And since we are on logins, let's talk about payments too. We all know that Linux users don't donate, right? But, can you really blame them? On Windows 10 Store, I have bought CUDA, that I don't even use, just because the payment was one click away. GNOME software has a donation button too. Problem is, that it navigates us away, to whatever payment method. According to a study, that means that 8 out of 10 users will avoid to pay, and then multiply that, to all potential purchases a user may can have done. Payments should be inside software app, and GNOME should keep a wallet, exactly as it works everywhere else. But anyway, that is the least of my issues really. What really annoys me is that GNOME software misses a filter for Flatpak and GNOME maps. For example, I only want to see Flatpak apps, especially in Silverblue that Flatpak is the only choice. And moreover, I want one more filter to display me only the apps that are created specifically for GNOME desktop. Besides, it is called GNOME software, and it is literally impossible to discover any GNOME app unless you check every app, one by one. To create a strong ecosystem, and bring people to GTK development, you should promote those apps, not hide them. Finally, I have added a post on Silverblue forums, that I raise concerns about Flatpak fragmentation, through the multiple Flatpak repos, since it will make the platform less attractive for app authors. I got a link on YouTube description, if you want to check it out. There are more things I don't like in GNOME software, but for now, I believe that the discoverability of the apps is by far the top issue. And here is a glorious confession. I haven't watched Chunichpo Season 2. Because I totally love this anime, and I don't want to change that.